Hello YouTube, I got a new tool for you and it's super easy to use and you can install it in about 5 to 10 minutes, maybe even less, but that's after watching my video of course. And you'll be turning static images into videos up to 2 minutes long. Here's a sample of what this tool can do. I would just like to point out that the music and the sound effects came from me and the video generator just made the video itself, just so you're not expecting sound from this. So technically you're just going to GitHub and downloading something and then unzipping something and then updating. And it's really that easy. But let me show you how it's done because there is some room to mess up and run into conflicts. Just a heads up, this tool is going to be about like 2 to 3 gigs, and then when you extract it, it's going to be 6 gigs, and then it's going to download like 50 more gigs of stuff. And it's currently only for NVIDIA. So sorry for the 100th time AMD folks. Also note, when the tool is downloading the 50 gigs of stuff, it's going to take a couple minutes as well. So your computer is not broken. It's just taking a long time to install a lot of things on your PC. So the first thing you need to do is go to the official GitHub page and click on the download link. So if you scroll down halfway, you'll see the installation section. Click on the blue hyperlink and your download should get started. Now this installer is great because it has everything that you need inside. It has CUDA 12.6, Python 2.6, all built in a portable version, and also Python 3.10, which is pretty amazing because a lot of things could go wrong if you had to install each one of these individually. So I appreciate lllyasviel or Zhang for making this tool more available to people. By the way, the guy who brought us this FramePack tool also brought us ControlNet, which is perhaps the best AI art tool ever made. At least the most significant one. Now, when your download's finished, go ahead and right click on the file and then unzip it somewhere. So I got WinRAR, so I'm just gonna do this and extract it to the folder called FramePack. Now this is gonna take a while because you're extracting a 1.68 or 2 gig RAR file that turns into 6 gigs. So it's packed pretty tightly. Don't worry, it's not broken. It's just taking a while. Now when everything's extracted, you can see here the top one here is my FramePack. You can go in here and click on the folders to get there. And this is the main folder that you want to be in. It should have the environment, run, and update, and then the two folders, system and web UI. The first thing you want to do is click on the update folder to update things. This is usually pretty quick, and it probably won't take long until there's another update. And the next thing you want to do is click on the run. Now, this one's going to take significantly longer. And by the way, when you click on any bat file, including this update and run file, you're always going to get the Windows Protected Your PC Windows Defender smart screen. Now this is just part of the smart screen feature, and you're gonna have to click on learn more or more and then click on run anyways. This will happen for any time you open a bat file or scripts that install stuff. So pretty much all open source tools are gonna run into this issue because it doesn't really have a cert and it's not a thing yet. It's an experimental tool on GitHub. So it makes sense that Windows is worried about this tool, but there's thousands, if not hundreds of thousands, people who I've already installed this tool and tested it, so it's community tested. Now, when you look at my screen, everything's already installed. So this is kind of when you're installed, this is what you're gonna get. And this is how you know the tool is running now. It says running on local URL right here, which is 127.0.0.1.7.8.6.0. And this is your loopback address and the port that it's using, the 7.8.6.0. This is pretty standard for most tools that run locally on your computer, which it is running locally. It's not calling outside IP address. This is a loopback address. Now, since this is gonna be your first time, it's going to take about maybe 10 minutes to install because it's going to be installing a lot of things. It's going to be installing about 50, 60 gigs of stuff. So just be patient. A problem that I ran into the first time is that I kept getting a click to continue and it would just close the command prompt. And so you don't want that. So what I did is I just restarted my computer and it was the easiest fix. and it actually worked the next time. I did have to uninstall it, then reinstall it, which uninstalling is basically just deleting it and then going through the motions again, which is extracting it somewhere, then clicking on the update and then run again. Now, other things that you can try is installing a local version of Python or CUDA drivers, which I wouldn't recommend it unless the restart doesn't work and you tried everything, but that's another thing you can do. But when you install Python, make sure you click on add Python to path, or you're gonna have a lot of heartache. You're gonna be watching a lot of tutorials and wondering why like their commands doesn't work the same way as yours does. And I would just do that and then try to run it again if you get issues. But there is already a portable version of Python on these files as well as CUDA, so it should work in theory. And really the only thing you're probably running into is some sort of conflict. But once it says running a local URL, it's going to open up automatically on your default browser like this. So the tool is very simple. And so you just have an area here where you can click on it and upload an image. You can also drag an image in here. So let's try it right now. Let me add this image right here. Then you type something in the prompt. And I just put something simple, but something you need to do is specify that the Valkyrie here has wings and a helmet with horns, or it's going to get confused. So you just, if something's kind of unusual, you just have to point it out. And then you scroll down a little bit. And from here, you could just actually start the generation. But there's some options here. So tcache, if you want it to go faster, you can uncheck it. But it says that it makes the finger slightly worse. So everything here is pretty well defined. They basically have what the setting does here and define it. Now, video length, I'm going to make this one 10 seconds, which I recommend that you do about 10 seconds for your videos, which is going to take about 15 to 20 minutes. Just plan on an average of 1 minute per second. Steps, I wouldn't change that, but the higher you go, the better the quality is, but you don't want to be sitting here forever. And then the distilled CFG scale, same with the CFG scale when you're doing AI art. I wouldn't recommend changing this. Maybe in Comfy UI, it'd be worth changing it, but I don't really think you should do it here. Then you have GPU inference preserve memory, and it says larger means slower. This next setting, GPU inference preserve memory, is probably the most important setting for everyone to understand because it's going to vary for each different computer. So it really depends on your video card here. But basically this number is the amount of VRAM that you have. And by default, it's set to 6. So you're only going to use 6 GB of VRAM if you don't change this. But if you have something like an RTX 4070, which I have 16 GB of VRAM. So I'm going to set it to 14 GB of VRAM because I don't want to use the full 16 because my computer is just going to crash as soon as I do anything else. Plus there's other stuff running in the background, so you don't want to use your computer if you put it to 14 and you're at like 80% or 90% capacity in your VRAM. Just let it do its thing. But if you get an OOM error over here in the command prompt, that means that it's out of memory and you're going to have to lower that value or stop doing stuff in the background. You can also click on this right here to reset it. Here's a short clip of a zombie, which is pretty creepy. So NSFW does work, blood, gore, and also nudity. So nudity does work. So be careful what you put, but you're not going to get that kind of content unless you ask for it. So you have to be very specific.
Oh no!
After that, you have MP4 compression, which is going to give you better quality the higher you raise it. But it's saying here, if you get black screens, put it back down to 16. And that's basically it. Now all you do is just click on start generation. Now over here in finish frames, it's gonna start creating the video pretty quickly. So every second that it makes, it's gonna put a video of that in here. So whether you're at like 1 second or 5 seconds, it's gonna have that 1 or 5 second video here until you get to the finished product. And you could even download it while it's at 5 seconds if you decide that you don't want this video anymore. You just want 5 seconds of it. You can go ahead and do that. Now, if you look at your command prompt, you can see that the autoencoder and codec that it uses is the Huan video, which is a pretty good generator. Then you'll see as it goes through the frames that there's going to be multiple loading bars. Something else that you can see is it's only using 6 GB of VRAM, which is perfect for a lot of people that don't have enough VRAM to run a lot of AI tools. This is the tool for you to run it on your computer locally and not wait forever, as well as not be restricted, because you could do anything from NSFW as well as, you know, make something that's over 1 minute long, which most video generators are like 2 to 3 seconds, which is really nothing. You can't do anything with 2 to 3 seconds. This one provides some pretty good results. It's not always perfect, but pretty good results in a decent amount of time. All right, so let's take a look at some of the videos I created and see which ones were good and which ones were bad. You can definitely use part of the video if it's not all good. You can see here she's having trouble finding her step and she kind of stumbles a little bit, but there is a good 1 second there you can use. If you had like a 30 second video, you could probably use a lot more than 1 second. So that's my advice, create a longer video once you get something you like and then use part of it. Now here's a girl in a painting walking slowly forward. It's a little bit weird, but it's not one of the successful ones, but still pretty cool to see a painting walk. Now here's one of the videos that came out pretty good, and it's basically just this girl in a painting that comes to life, and there's slight movement in the background, but you can barely notice it, but you definitely can see her talking, and you could probably put something voice over there, but pretty cool that this thing came out flawlessly, and it's about 30 seconds long. Now I have this flower here with some words in the middle, so I didn't want the words to move, so I specified that in the prompt, and I also said that there's a sunset and the water is moving and the wind is slightly blowing the flower. Now here's a cool picture come to life. It's a little bit more cartoony than the original picture, but it's still a pretty cool effect. Now here's an image of a cowgirl come to life, and she's doing a little TikTok dance here, and her movements are slightly weird, but it still looks pretty good for an image that was animated. Now here's another one with a painting or drawing, anime slash whatever, come to life, and there is some weird stuff going on with her hands there, but overall it's pretty good aside from the hands. And I used this elf girl a couple times. Here's a walk, just kind of a short 10 second walk, and it came out pretty good. Now here's another one of the same elf girl walking, and so she's just slowly walking forward towards the camera. It's actually pretty good, and something you really got to specify on elves is their ears, because the ears will disappear if it's trying to keep it more like a normal human being. Now here's another one of the elf girls. She's walking, but she's also smiling now, so it actually gave her teeth and everything, and the smile came out pretty good, and it looks pretty crazy. Now here's a better example why it's important to say that the girl has cat ears. You can see here, you can see her ears are disappearing every now and then, and this is because I didn't specify that she has ears on her head, so it eventually disappeared, but then it comes back after a while. So definitely if they have ears, say they have ears, because that's not normal. This one, I specified that she has ears, and you can see that the ears don't disappear, and it works pretty good. I recommend creating 5 to 10 second videos until you get the hang of it, and then you could create longer ones and walk away and just wait for it to generate. Now here's a video that's pretty subtle. It's kind of like something you would have on a wallpaper or screensaver or something like that, but it does a pretty cool effect. Now here's another video of something I used in my earlier clip, but as you can see, the cape is kind of doing some weird stuff, so I cropped it in so you didn't see the cape. But I wonder if I made it any longer, if it would actually show some hair when she pulled her hood back. Now here's another girl dancing. This one's a little weird, but I mean, some people do dance this way, but her hip or her body isn't really moving that much, and it's mostly her arms. Here's another one where I just wanted the background to move and the character to stay still, and this is something that's pretty nice for like a wallpaper or something like that. Here's a video of a dark sorcerer with a skull face, and I created this with Flux and animated it, which is pretty amazing how it's opening its mouth. Pretty creepy. Next we have this sorcerer, and she's casting a spell, a fireball spell, and the fire looks very good, and she's also like talking under her breath, like casting a spell or something like that. Her hair didn't move as much as I wanted, but it does have this kind of ethereal slow movement, as well as her gown in the background. Now I had to describe this, her talking to herself, casting a spell, as well as her hair and her gown slowly flying, as well as the type of fireball. So definitely be more descriptive, and it should do a pretty good job. Also, don't forget about the ears. If you don't say it's an elf with elf ears, it's just the ears are probably going to disappear. Now here's one of my longer videos, and it's 26 seconds, but I actually wanted 2 minutes, but I don't know what happened. I can't seem to get 2 minutes right now, and I don't know if it's just me or everyone, but it seems to cap out at 26 to 30 seconds. But it did a very good job with this cute little doll doing some sort of dance, but it turned out pretty good. Now here's a video that would be good for a loop, and it's just kind of doing the same kind of motions over and over, and her wings slightly move, and at the end she kind of backs up and kind of raises into the sky. It's kind of a shame, because it seemed like it was going to do something cool, and it just ended. Now here's another one that's really cool, and I like this one a lot. It looks pretty convincing. It's this pink unicorn dragon slash whatever dinosaur, and it turned out pretty good, and it looks like some weird kind of, I don't know, gremlin. It looks pretty cool. But again, it's a shame that it put its hands on the ground at the end of the video. It looked like it was going to do something cool, and then it just ended. But this is an amazing tool, and if you want to download and install it now, all you got to do is download it and then click on the run.bat or update.bat, then run.bat. And it's that simple, and you can get started right now. Just a few tips. If there's something weird, like a horn or something on a girl's head, like ears that shouldn't be on human, then you definitely have to state that. Or if they're wearing a hat or headphones, you have to specify that they're wearing that, or it's going to disappear throughout the scene because it's not normal. And also, if you want something to stay static, like a word that's attached to something, you gotta say so, say that the words don't move. But other than that, it's just as simple as uploading a picture and then putting in a prompt. And then you get a video like this. And if you want to extend the video that you already have, you can actually take the last frame, take a screenshot, then throw it back in this tool to make it again, which is a pretty neat thing that you can do. Well, I hope you have fun with this tool, and that's all I had to show you for now. Maybe next time I'll show you how to put it in comfy UI once I experiment more with that. Well, I hope you liked the video, and if you did, just give it a thumbs up. It helps me out a lot. Also, if you like things like AI music or AI art, go ahead and check out the videos that should be showing up right there and right there. Thanks a lot. Bye.